So, let's talk about Marmaduke.
I have a feeling you guys have a lot of questions to say. Like, where the fridge did this film come from and how did it manage to get onto Netflix? Well, I don't know if there's a basic reason, since this film was based off on the book and it's mostly like the live action film with the same name. But to be honest, I don't see the point of this at all. Like, we already have a Marmaduke movie, so what is the point in having this? Well, it was due to Netflix, of course, because maybe they wanted to have some animated films under the belt. I don't know. That's the only reason I can think of. And put the opportunity to put Marmaduke onto Netflix collection. Oh my god, this is gonna suck big time, isn't it? Let's find out. Okay, let me start with the plot first, because even I'm starting to have a big time to what to do with this. Okay, so it's mostly about Marmaduke being independent and just try to win a sports or win like a dog show competition. That's basically what the story is. It's basically just that. But there are other stuff that make this story horrendously awful. And it becomes so out of focus that it always tries to repeat the same thing over and over to give Marmaduke a reminder that he has to prove his goal. Or maybe that's just the character himself that just trying to remind each other every time because it might be stupid. That actually makes a lot of sense. But yes, there's the plot that is just awfully used and very odd, terrible pacing and all of that. But there are other three things that make this film even more insufferable. There's a giant pile of plot twist that goes absolutely nowhere, of course. Second is that they always have to replay every single clip just because it is too lazy to make another bloody clip. And third and finally is with the humor. This isn't just your generic gas humor that's too low brow for an Adam Sandler movie. That makes normal the North humor look like some of the humor in Emperor's New Groove. And let's not forget Marmaduke taking a dump in a trophy. Oh, Marmaduke, this is why you always have to blind me with your horrendous gas humor. Seriously, did the writers and the directors at least care into making a somewhat appealing story? I have never seen someone that a story so broken on Netflix that makes it completely insufferable to watch. But hey, I guess it's okay as long as Marmaduke's doing okay in his training, right? It's the animation that makes people think on how is it even possible for Netflix to accept a kind of animation like this. This is the kind of animation you would see in those cheap $1 director home media sequels or films or whatever. Not in a film that was released on Netflix, but yeah, there is that lowbrow humor that makes the film insufferable. But the animation is just ugly. And that couldn't be more obvious in the design of the characters. Was it too expensive for someone out there as a professional artist that can actually make good looking characters? But whereas some of the pets that look like they were done by an amateur, the humans look like they were done by a freaking toddler. Like, some of the males are a lot more skinny, and one of the females really have a thicker than a bowl of oatmeal. You know, like, for crying out loud, man. Good with these done on your job. Like, that was something that even I thought the Emoji Movie would be able to make. What was that? At least I can say that the Emoji Movie for the animators did a very good job at, like, in the character animation and maybe some of the backgrounds and even the humans as well. But in here, Marmaduke has no redeeming qualities whatsoever. The backgrounds are still pale with a generic town and art new city that's meant to be like a New York City kind of stuff thing. I don't know, they didn't explain it well. And even with the textures, it makes it even more unwatchable. Can't believe I have to do this again. But I had to blind myself with some kind of blanket or cover or whatever you want to do so I can continue watching the movie. But you know what? This animation could probably be one of Norman North qualities in kind of animation, if you know what I mean. Even for the character animation, I can see there's some talent in there, but the rendering came out so bad that the movements are so unnatural. It's even worse when they're trying to be like some kind of cartoon moves in such a cartoonist way that makes this film more insufferable. Now, I have seen bad animation back then, like with Food Fight, Norman the North, Polar Squad, and even the Emoji Movie. But Marmaduke takes this animation to a whole new level. So we have the obnoxious and unwatchable part of the way. Speaking of the characters, it is absolutely stupid. And I think these guys are more of these guys are not the greatest ones. But they're more insufferable than you think. Because most of these characters are just one-note gags, or either they have no purpose, or even have a single character in this film. And for in existence. Starting off with Marmaduke, he's the protagonist that just wants to be independent and try to win the dog competition, or whatever you want to call it. But there's a lot of things that we try to know about Marmaduke. Why does he talk with humans? What does it have to do with him and his love interest? And why does he want to become independent for so long? Who cares? Because the movie sure doesn't end. You know, just like busy bringing out too many gags. And of course, his trainer is called Guy Hilton, who is basically his trainer, who's literally just called Guy, which sounds like they're trying to copy Guy with the same name of Guy from The Croods. And then they'll see us, who is the villain that just tries to win, who's just trying to win the trophy in a fairly of a villainous way, which he barely has a sense of character and why does he win that trophy, which makes him just a complete waste of time. As for the rest of the characters, I just don't care. Like, they have no purpose, like, absolutely none of them. Like, most of these characters are just there to bring out gags, or just to remind Marmaduke to be fully trained and actually win the dog show. Making bland and no purpose to the characters is one thing, but when you have no intelligence into these characters, then they become even worse than anyone can think. In my years of watching anime films, the recent abysmal anime film I've seen is Polar Squad, and I hoped to see not now that I think about it, the last time I saw an abysmal anime film was Northern North Family Vacation, and I was hoping that there was one anime film that wouldn't become abysmal, so everything else can just be terrible or just good, and without and make sure they won't make another abysmal anime film ever to exist. But then came Marmaduke. Marmaduke and absolutely known to be one of the worst anime films I have ever seen in existence. The writing is abysmal. The story is unpleasant. The animation is disgusting. The humor is as worse, and the characters are unbearable. And God, and anyone with intelligence can't even survive watching this film for like 10 minutes. Like, I know there's probably gonna be people gonna be out there saying like it's for kids attitude, but seriously, who the frick you think you're talking to? Kids around 5 and under? Anyone can look at this and think that this is a ridiculous idea. I'm so happy to give this a zero of abysmal. Why would anyone even think of making this? Would always be a mystery. But we can all agree that Marmaduke will always be one of the worst anime films of all time.